Stop the World from Crying is all of our dad's favorite song. Collectively, every dad of every member of the band loves Stop the World from Crying. Easily the dad song. It's a great song. I was listening to a lot of lots of like classic rock, Beatles-y, David Bowie stuff, and I was also listening to a lot of Oasis at the time, and I kept saying to myself, like, why don't we have a song like that? Like, why don't we have one of those songs that's just got the basic rock formulas? It's got all the things that made everybody fall in love with rock in the early 60s and 70s. Why don't we have one of those? And so I came up with Stop the World from Crying, in my bedroom in like 20 minutes. And I was just like, here you go. Here's two parts. They sound good. It's epic. It's going to have some na-na-nas. It's going to have hand claps and piano. It's going to have everything. It's going to have all the stuff. And I brought it to the band and everyone really loved it. And when we recorded it, I think that's when it really came to light. I don't remember if we had played the song live before we recorded it. But I remember when we heard it back, we were like, wow, like this song is huge. It is just huge, huge rock song. Just a terrific, terrific song. Easily one of the top 10 favorite songs. And an iconic Doublethink song, just because it, for whatever reason, it touched so many people. People just love it. They love the lyrics. They love the sentimentality of it. They love the hugeness of it. It's just a very identifiable track by us, and also kind of notable that there really isn't any other Doublethink song like it. Like, we did it once and we were like, all right, we can only really do this once. I mean, if every song we did all sounded like Stop the World from Crying, we'd be a pretty boring band. But because we did it once and did it really well that one time, it made it stand out even more. Terrific, terrific song. So the song is not a breakup song, but a post-breakup song. It's a song about that weird time period that people go in when they're in relationships, where they've ended a relationship, and for the next, like, 6 months afterwards, they're still thinking about, that relationship and still thinking about their now ex-boyfriend or girlfriend and trying to come to terms with the fact that that person is no longer in their life. And the song is essentially me writing a letter to this recent ex of mine. And basically being like, this is what's going on with me. And I hope that things are going okay with you, kind of thing. And the Stop the World from Crying line is specifically my being overly ambitious to the point of detriment to my own relationship. It was kind of like an apology almost, like, her saying like, well, what are you doing? And I'm like, well, I'm still trying to stop the world from crying, which is like obviously ridiculous. You can't fucking do that. But that would be something that that I would say. I would say like, oh yeah, I'm gonna do that, and obviously not ever do it because it's just impossible. But keep trying to do it, and even if it alienates the people that are the most close to me. So that's kind of what the song represents. It's an apology letter to the past. Hey everyone, this is Scott from Doublethink. Is this one of your favorite songs? Leave a comment about it below. I hope you're enjoying these track-by-track videos for all the songs on the new collection of Doublethink music called Keep the Wolves at Bay. If you would like to get a copy of this retrospective album, please click the link in the description of this video to head to our Indiegogo page where you'll be able to reserve your copy. Hope to see you guys soon.